I'm Andy James here with the Texas A&M AgriLife Extension and Institute for Renewable Natural Resources. And today we're here on the Hannah Ranch in Quail County, Texas. And we're going to talk a little bit about the importance of using grazing management to benefit quail habitat. Today I have Jeff Goodwin, who is the State Range Specialist for the Natural Resources Conservation Service. And I'm going to let him talk to you a little bit about how to set a stocking rate and how we can ensure we've got enough grass on the ground for our livestock and our quail. Jeff?
Thanks, Andy. And I agree, one of the main points that we want to talk about on a lot of these ranches that are multi-purpose, where they manage for livestock as well as quail habitat, is one of the key things is stocking rate. Most of these ranches are in the business of cattle production, but they're also in the business of quail hunting. So we're really using cattle more of as a tool for habitat management. We're moving more and more into that. So it's really important to get those stocking rates right that are going to benefit the habitat for the cattle as well as the habitat for the quail.
Absolutely.
So as we kind of look at stocking rate is one of the things that from the standpoint of grazing management, it's probably the most important decision that a landowner can make. They don't have a lot of control over the rain that they get. They don't have a lot of control over the soils that are on their ranch, but they do have control over how many of the kinds and amounts of forage that they can manage and how much is taken. And that's all done through stocking rate. So when you want to determine a stocking rate, you need basically two things. You need to know simple supply and demand. You need to know how much grass a cow needs to graze for a year, which is the demand portion. And then you need to know supply. How much grass do we have? And then how much can we actually utilize to not only keep the health of that plant and keep it vigorous, but also to maintain some quail habitat. Just like this plant right here, for instance, little blue stem is probably one of the primary nesting plants for quail. So we would kind of, on a site like this, we would want to probably tend to use that as one of our key species for when we're managing these pastures. So when we talk about supply and demand, the first thing we do is determine what that supply is. So a real easy way to do that, when we talk about stocking rates and determining supply and production, and there's a lot of complicated ways to do this, but there's some real easy ones too, and that's what we'd like to talk about today. This is what we call a grazing stick. It could be a yardstick. It could be anything you got around the house. This one typically has a lot of calculations on it that'll help you make some of those decisions. But what we're going to use it for today is actually determining that demand. So if you were to take this and lay it down and make a square, that's one square yard, right? Okay. If you take a square yard of forage, clip it to the ground. We want total forage to determine our supply. Clip it all the way to the ground and bag it. Then we want to dry it somehow. So, you know, we can use a microwave, things like that. The easiest way is to sit it on the dash of your pickup or something for a couple of days. Let it dry down, weigh it in grams, and multiply your production by 10.7. If you multiply one square yard's production by 10.7, that'll give you pounds per acre. And that's really what we're looking at. That's what we're looking at when we want to know what the production is get it into that pounds per acre. That's how we can kind of relate to this. So this works on Bermuda grass. It works on native rangeland like this. It's just a measurement of production.